Today we will see how to do some questions in OpenOffice Calc for the project work of class 9. So this is one question. You have to create a table in which you have to enter name, tuition fees, lab fees and development charges of some students. And then you have to find total fees. Then you have to find GST as 12% of total fees, net fees, that will be GST plus total fees. Then maximum, average, minimum, all these things we will find in this table. Then we will create a column chart or bar chart on the table. So let us do these questions one by one. So first of all, we have to make this table in Excel or OpenOffice Calc. So the table is already made by me. So this is the table. There are a few names here: tuition fees of the students, lab fees, development charges. Now we have to write the formula to find total fees. And total fees will be what? It will be tuition fees plus lab fees plus development charges. So we will write equal to. To start any formula, we write equal to, then B2, we will click on tuition fees, we'll get B2 plus C2 plus, we'll click on development charges, we'll get D2. So B2 plus C2 plus D2 and press enter, you are getting the total fees for one student, then drag by using fill handle to get the total fees for rest of the students. Now the next question is, GST is 12% of total fees. So 12% of total fees. Total fees is in E2. So we will write equal to 12 upon 100 because 12% of E2 we have to find into and click on E2. So this is the GST. So this is 12 upon 100 into E2. 12 upon 100 into the total fees. That is the 12% of that particular value. Then select the range and drag the formula. Now we have to find net fees, which will be total fees plus GST. So that will be equal to, click on total fees E2 plus, click on GST F2. So E2 plus F2, this is the net fees formula. And then drag it for rest of the cells. So this, your table is complete now. Now let us go to the next question. Now we have to find maximum net fees and average tuition fees. So maximum net fees. So this is net fees. To find maximum, we will write equal to max, and max is the formula to find maximum value, and select the range. When we select the range, it is showing G2 colon G5 because this is a range in which we have to find the maximum value. Press enter. 6608 is the maximum value in the range. So this is the formula which we have to write equal to max D2 colon G5 for net fees. Now the next part is average tuition fees we have to find. Now for average, we will write the formula, that is average. So we have to find equal to average, bracket open, select the range of tuition fees B2 colon B5. This is the formula, equal to average in the round brackets, select the range, press enter. So 3050 is the average tuition fees. Next is minimum lab fees. So this is the lab fees. Below that we are putting our cursor, equal to MIN for minimum, open the round brackets, select the range of lab fees C2 colon C5, bracket close, enter. So 400 is the minimum lab fees here in this range. Then we have to create a column or bar chart on the table. So to create a column chart, we will go to insert. Then we'll click on chart. Okay, so before that, select the table on which you have to make a chart. Before making a chart, first of all, select the table. When you are selecting the table, make sure you are not taking any extra row or column. Don't select these rows in which we have found a minimum, maximum or average. There is no need to select that row. Okay, so I'm just selecting the table and not selecting the row which contains minimum, maximum and average value. Go to insert, go to chart. Now select the type of chart we have to make. Suppose I am taking the column chart. As per the question, we can create column or bar chart. So suppose I am taking column chart in the first column chart from here. Click on next. Data range is already selected. Click on next. We can give a title for the chart. Title is suppose fees details that we are giving here. And you can just drag it and see in the x-axis names are there. So the title for x-axis, we can give name. Y-axis contains the fees. I can simply write fees in the y-axis as the heading. Click on finish. So now you can see the marks. These are the fees. Blue color is the tuition fees. So Anne has got this much tuition fees. Green color is for total fees. blue is for net fees, orange is for lab fees. So all these are coming over here. You can just simply drag it to different location, the chart on the Excel sheet. Okay, now the next is you have to add fee details on the top of the table and use merge and center. So now I have to add the heading for the table on the top. So first of all, I need to insert a row on the top. To insert a row on the top, place a cursor on the first row, go to insert, click on rows. Okay, so the row is inserted here. Now you have to write the heading fee details. So I'm writing fee. So the cursor should be here, fees details. Okay, now we have to place this heading in the center of the table. So we select the entire cells which contains the complete table, that is column number A to column G. We are selecting all the cells from column A1 to G1. And now we want this fee details to come in the center of this row. Now this is the tool which is used to merge the cells. Merge means combining the cells, and you can see between the borders, between the cells are not coming. And now I click on the this center alignment button to center align the text. So first of all, we have merged all the cells, combined all the cells into one cell, and then we click on the center alignment button. And if I want, I can increase the font size so that the heading looks a little bit large size as compared to the rest of the text. I can also change the color of the row which contains the heading. So take any color from here which you want. Okay, now next question is change the color of the table cells. So that I have already done. Similarly, you can change the color of this heading. So I am selecting this and select any color for the heading. So this is the color for the heading I have selected. Similarly, you can change the color for rest of the cells. Select the cells and change the color as per your interest, as per your requirement. Okay, so this way we have done this first question of the practical. Okay, the project work. The next question is you have to create a table to store the name and salary of the employees and find bonuses 10% of salary, find taxes 5% of salary, total salary and average. So in the same manner like we have done how to find GST as 12% of total fees, similarly you can find tax and bonus also for the salary. So it will be done in the same manner, and then you can use average function to find average total salary. Same manner, we are having the other table in which we are having train ID, ticket cost and number of passengers. We will find total cost. We will multiply number of passengers with ticket cost. Multiply these two values, we will get the total cost. So this is the cost for one passenger. For four passengers, we have to multiply the number of passengers with ticket cost. Give heading train booking as shown. So this is the same way how we have entered the heading here. First of all, you will insert a row on the top, insert rows. You will place a cursor on the first row and insert rows, and then you will write the heading, click on this tool for merge cells, and then you can center align the heading. So this question is already there in the first, similar to the first question. Now creating a pie chart. Now when we are creating a pie chart, suppose on this table, if I have to make a pie chart, I'll go to insert. First of all, one more thing, when you are making a pie chart, you can select only two columns. Only one column should be the numeric column, the value column. Only one column should be the value column. One column I am taking as name. Pie chart is made of only two columns. One is the name, okay, and second is the number values, the value column. So insert chart. So I am taking only two columns, name and tuition fees, for creating a pie chart. So you take a pie chart from here, select any type of pie chart, click on next. Next, specify any title for the chart, okay, and click on finish. So this is the pie chart which is being made over here, and similarly you can make a pie chart for the table given in the next question. Okay, now we are coming to the next question. This is the next question in which we have to enter few values for principal and time, and then rate of interest is fixed by using absolute referencing. You have to use absolute referencing. So rate of interest is fixed at 12%, and then we have to find simple interest. So now we will do this question. So this is rate of interest. I have written here. We have written 12 here. 12 is the value for rate of interest. Principal, time and simple interest we have to find. So I am entering some value for principal amount. Suppose these values I have entered for principal. Suppose for time I am entering these values. So the formula is principal into rate into time upon 100, P into R into D upon 100 for interest. So equal to P then into rate R into P upon 100. So this is the formula P into R into T upon 100. This is the formula for simple interest. Principal A3 into R B1 into time B3 in upon 100. So this is the formula. Now what we want is when we are dragging this formula, it will not give the correct answer because for the value of time, it is showing B3, but the value of rate of interest is fixed at B1. So now you can see the rate of interest is shown in B2, but it is fixed at B1. So what we should do to make this rate of interest fixed? We have to use absolute referencing. That is, A3 is principal, B1 is rate of interest, which we need to fix for all the values. We will place dollar sign like this, dollar B, dollar one. So that means our principal and time will change, but rate of interest will be same for all these values, all these four values of principal and time. The rate of interest will be same. It will be 12% for all of them. So what we have done, A3 principal into dollar B, dollar one. So instead of B1, we will write dollar B, dollar one into and then the time value and press enter. And now when we drag it, we will see when we are using this formula for this cell, it is A4. So principal has changed from A3 to A4, B1. This B1 is still fixed for the second value and B4. Time is changed for B4. It was B3 for the first value, now it is B4. And similarly, you can see A6 has changed, B6 has changed, but B1 is again same. So this is how we will use absolute referencing to keep a particular value fixed. We will use dollar sign in the cell address. So this was your question. Same way, if we have to enter the item names and price and quantity for 5 items, we will find total cost by multiplying price and quantity. Similarly, we will fix the value of GST at 10% and then we find total cost with GST. So this question also we will do. So first of all, we will enter the details of any few items. So item names. Okay, suppose these items, price, of eraser, price of box, and quantity. So quantity, suppose 2 and box. Okay, now total cost. So total cost will be like, suppose let me first increase the size of this particular table, and total cost will be price into quantity. This is item name, price and quantity of few items. So equal to, click on price into, click on quantity and press enter, and then select the fill handle. By using the fill handle, you can get the total cost for rest of the items. Now you have to find GST is fixed at 10%. So we have to fix GST. So suppose I'm writing the value of GST somewhere. Suppose here I'm writing GST. Okay, here I'm writing GST. And it is fixed at 10%. So what we have to find? We have to find total cost with GST. So first of all, we will find what is the GST on this total cost. So GST, we have to find here. Okay, GST amount. And then we will find total cost with GST. तो अभी हमें ये निकालना है कि हमारा GST कितना है. अगर हमारा total cost 40,000 है, what will be the GST which will be we have to pay it on this total cost. So we will write equal to, click on D2 into 10 upon 100. So this much GST we have to pay on this total cost. So this is the GST amount. So D2 into 10 upon 100, because GST was 10%. Okay. Or we can simply write, according to the question, we have to use absolute referencing. So what we can do is we can use the value of GST is given in B8. So D2 into B8 upon 100. Okay. Now this B8 is fixed. So what we can do is we can write dollar b dollar 8 upon 100. So d2 into dollar b dollar 8 upon 100, because for all these total costs the value of GST will remain the same, the percentage value of GST will be same. So drag it and you will get, and you will see here also d5 is the total cost, b8 is same here for this particular amount of total cost also. Now to find total cost with GST, we have to write equal to total cost plus GST. Add both of them, you have, this is the total cost which you have to pay after paying the GST amount. So this is how we have to find the total cost with GST. Add both of these values. Okay, so this was your question number 5. So I hope you are able to understand this question now.